Hi, this is Alfauzia Nihar from At Home Tuition. Welcome to our session today. The topic that we are going to discuss in our today's video is Poisson distribution. In this video, we are going to discuss the important properties of Poisson distribution, its definition, formula, and its application, also its characteristics. Okay, let us start with the definition of the Poisson distribution. The Poisson distribution is a discrete probability distribution for the counts of events that occur randomly in a given interval of time. Okay, Poisson distribution is generally denoted by this one, P of X. You can look at this formula. We have lambda, capital X, small x in this formula. Okay, I'll explain you what this formula is denoting. If we let X, the capital X, as the number of events in a given interval, and this lambda is nothing but mean number of events per interval, the probability of observing X events in a given interval will be given by e raised to negative lambda times lambda raised to X divided by X factorial. X can be any number from 0 to infinity, and e is nothing but a mathematical constant. Hope you all know the value for e. E is nothing but it is approximately equal to 2.718. Hope you are clear with the formula. The probability of events occurring at a specific time is Poisson distribution. In other words, you can say that when you are aware of how often the event happened, Poisson distribution can be used to predict how often that event will occur. It provides the likelihood of a given number of events occurring in a set period. Okay, hope you got an idea on the definition and the formula of the Poisson distribution. Now let us see Poisson distribution characteristics. Now let us see the important characteristics of Poisson distribution. First important characteristics is an event can happen any amount of times throughout a period. So this is the first characteristic. And the second one is events occurring don't affect the probability of another event that also occurs within the same period. Okay, they are independent, it won't affect the other one. And the occurrence rate is constant, it will not change based on the time. And fourth important characteristic is the likelihood of an occurring event corresponds to the time length. Okay, these are the characteristics of Poisson distribution. So if you get problem and you understand that if these characteristics are there in the question, then you can identify that the question is from the Poisson distribution topic. X here is nothing but the actual number of occurring successes, and lambda is the average number of successes within the specified region. Let us see an example and check how this formula is applicable in a real life example. Please have a glance over this example. Births in a hospital occur randomly at an event at an average rate of 1.8 births per hour. What is the probability of observing 4 births in a given hour at the hospital? Okay, let X be the number of births given in an hour, and events occur randomly. So X is equal to 1.8. And what is the mean rate here? Okay, X is mean rate is 1.8 and X is 4 births. So let's identify the given information and plug those values in the formula. We can now use the formula to calculate the probability of observing exactly 4 births in a given hour. So let me rewrite the same question in symbolic form. Now all we have to do is solve this algebraically. So I'm using a calculator, so I get 0.0723. Hope you get the same answer. So this example is exact case. What about the probability of more than or equal to 2 births in a given hour at a hospital? Okay, I'll just write it both in a statement form and symbolic way. More than or equal to. So if you write it symbolically, it is nothing but greater than or equal to, right? It means we want to find probability of X greater than or equal to 2. So you have to start from 2. Probability of X is equal to 2 plus probability of X is equal to 3, and it keeps on going. That is, an infinite number of probabilities have to be calculated for this part. Am I right? Do you think it is possible? Yes, it cannot be found because infinite number of probability is not that easy to calculate. We can't find till the infinity numbers. So I'm just going to rewrite the formula for this case. In case if you get greater than or equal to problem, you can write the formula as 1 minus probability of x less than. Just like the probability concept. A complement means 1 minus probability of that event, no? The same case here. Probability of an event is equal to 1 minus probability of not that event. The opposite for greater than or equal to is less than. Does this make sense to you so far? Now let's find the probability of x less than 2. See, in two birds, less than 2 means you have to start from 0. 0 and 1. Am I right? So you have to find the probability of x is equal to 0 and probability of x is equal to 1 and then add here. So I'm going to replace this part. We need to find the probability of x less than 2. It means what are the numbers lesser than 2? 0 and 1. So you have to find the probability separately for 0 and 1 and then add. This answer together will give you the probability of x less than 2. Does this make sense to you? Okay. Since this is a Poisson distribution problem, we are going to apply the Poisson distribution formula here. Here you should know that 0 factorial is equal to 1. 1 factorial is equal to 1 and any number or any term raised to 0 is also equal to 1. Okay, so you can do the calculation. You can find the values for these two and add and subtract it from 1. Hope you get the same answer. Hope you're clear with this example. Here I'd like to give you a small difference between a Poisson random variable and the binomial distribution. A Poisson random variable can take on any positive integer value. In contrast, the binomial distribution always has a finite upper limit. Okay, let's now discuss the properties of Poisson distribution. Poisson distribution is defined by single parameter lambda. And mean is lambda here. And variance is also equal to lambda here. So, in Poisson distribution, the important property you should know is variance and mean are equal. Hope you got an idea on the properties now. Okay, now let us see the conditions for Poisson distribution. Poisson distribution is the limiting case of the binomial distribution under certain assumptions. Let me give you the assumptions. Here are the list of limitations for a Poisson distribution to become a binomial. Okay, the number of trials, n, should be indefinitely large. So that is the first assumption. And second one is the probability of success p for each trial is indefinitely small. And third limitation is np is equal to lambda. That should be finite when lambda is the constant one. Hope you are clear with the condition for Poisson distribution. Okay. Now let us see the application of Poisson distribution. Poisson distribution is used in quality control statistics. It is used in quality control statistics to count the number of defects in an item. In biology, it is helpful to count the number of bacteria and in determining the number of deaths in a district in a given period by rare disease. The number of error per page in typed material. Next application is the number of plants infected with a particular disease in a plot of field. Number of weeds in particular species in different plots of field. So these are the few applications of Poisson distribution. By looking at the problems under this topic Poisson distribution, you can get an idea that for all the negative things, this distribution will be applicable. Calculating Poisson probabilities ideally requires a statistical calculator. If you think about the features of Poisson distribution, it has several unique features. Most distinctively unique feature is it has only one parameter. And another important feature is Poisson distribution is not symmetrical. It is skewed towards the infinity n. And the mean of any Poisson distribution is equal to its variance, what we discussed in the characteristics. That is the unique property of this distribution. In no other distribution you can see this property. Mean and variance are equal. The situations to which Poisson distributions apply are diverse and it is not always easy to see at first glance that they are specimens of one underlying type. Okay, I have listed out the negative concepts, no? Only in those concepts Poisson distribution will be applicable. So please keep in mind that All we have to work with are rate of occurrence and window of observation, the time span, I mean the period, and the number of times the event. Poisson distribution has a strong theoretical background and it is very wide spectrum of the practical applications. Here is the summary of the Poisson distribution. It deals with mutually independent events and it occurs at a known and a constant rate per unit. It is observed over a certain unit of time or space and it can be calculated using the formula. The rate R or the rate is expected or most likely outcome that should be greater than 1. And it is symmetrical and it is skewed more or less towards the high end. Okay. So in case if you get any query regarding this topic, kindly let me know. See you in the next video. Have a great day.